हेलो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू आर डूइंग वेल। यू गॉट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फ्रॉम TCS। योर जॉइनिंग इज कंप्लीटेड, योर ऑनबोर्डिंग इज कंप्लीटेड, यू हैव रिसीव्ड योर एम्प्लॉय आईडी, यू हैव रिसीव्ड योर आई कार्ड, यू हैव रिसीव्ड योर लैपटॉप्स एंड अदर एसेंशियल डॉक्यूमेंट्स। यू गॉट टू नो अबाउट योर मैनेजर एंड द प्रोजेक्ट वेयर यू विल बी वर्किंग एंड योर ट्रेनिंग इज ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड। But after 1 or 2 weeks, you suddenly got call from HR or a mail from HR that you cannot continue working with TCS because your background verification result is negative. In this video, we will discuss about background verification. Basically, I have covered this video for TCS specific background verification, but this process is universal for all the MNCs. That means that this process is followed in all the organization. So in this video, I will cover what is background verification check, what all the documents are checked during background verification process, how much time background verification process takes. If you don't have a particular document and your HR is asking that document for background verification, so how you will provide that document? And if you don't have that document, how you will deal with this situation? Who conduct the background verification process and what will happen if you fail in background verification process? So let's start. Or BGC, background verification or background check. It is a verification process conducted by your current company. Suppose you have joined TCS, so the background verification BGV will be conducted by TCS to check whether the information you have provided during your interview, the information you have written in your resume or CV, that is genuine. Genuine in the sense your educational details or educational information you have provided in your resume, in your biodata, the work experience you have provided, the salary you have mentioned during your interview with the HR, that all information is authentic and genuine. So this all the things are verified during background verification or background check. During background verification or background check, what all documents are checked? So first, address proof, that is your voter ID, your passport, electricity bill, or if you are a tenant, your agreement or rent agreement document. Second document is your educational proof, that is your mark sheet and certificate. Suppose if you are B Pharma student or if you are a BTech student, your mark sheet, all the mark sheet of the all semesters, and certificate, provisional certificate. Third document is work or employment proof. So suppose you are an experienced candidate, you previously worked in an organization, let's say you have worked for Amazon, right now you have applied in TCS, so you have to provide your employment proof, that is offer letter from Amazon, relieving letter from Amazon and salary statement proof. So if you are an experienced employee, in that case only you have to provide your salary statement proof. So 3 months pay slip or 3 months bank statement should be provided to the background team. So now we will discuss about how much time the background verification process takes. For some company, the background verification process takes only 2 weeks. For some company, it takes from 45 days to 60 days. Now we will discuss, if you don't have a particular document while asked for background verification, how you will deal with it. So friends, it is completely a practical situation. In some of the cases, you may come across some situation where you don't have that particular document to provide to the company HR. Let me give you an example. Suppose you are an experienced employee. So you are working for a company and right now you are serving your notice period. So we all know, all the experienced candidates should know that after completion of the notice period, they get their relieving letter. So in that case, you should inform your HR about the notice period and you should inform your HR that you will provide the document after 30 days or for 45 days of joining. Always take the maximum time, because sometimes it takes time more than expected. So it is always good to ask for maximum time. Similarly, if you are pursuing your education, you are in the last semester of your education and you have recently cracked an interview in TCS. So in that case also, you should inform your HR that you will get your degree or mark sheet after 30 days, 40 days or 50 days and you will provide it after joining the organization. So in that case, company may ask you to give them a declaration form. So the company will provide you the format of the declaration form. You just need to mention that this certificate you don't have right now. You will provide that certificate after 60 days, 90 days or 120 days. So that is how you will inform this to your HR. And suppose if you don't have that document and you will not get that document, so it is always important to inform the HR then and there after your selection, you are selected for that company. So the HR will decide and your candidature whether you should work for this company or not. So it is always important for you to inform the HR if you come across any of this situation. So now we will discuss about what will happen if you fail in background verification process. So why background verification is conducted? First, we need to know this. See friends, previously what happened? People used to provide false document, false salary statements, false experiences. So when they started working in the project, so in that time, the leadership or the team faced so many trouble when they got to know that this person don't have that relevant experience, that technical knowledge. So that is why to shortlist, to filter these kind of fake people, the company is very much strict about this background verification process. So that is why the background verification is conducted for all the companies. So this is a process to filter out the fake people and to get the genuine people with the relevant experience and relevant technical knowledge. So how it is like determined, or how it is like how HR get to know that you failed in the background verification process? So first I will tell you that in background verification process, the company, suppose if it is TCS, TCS gives the contract to third party which is expert in background verification process. So TCS talent team gives the list of 50 people for them. The background verification will be conducted. Based on the list, the third party will perform the thorough background verification. They will go to your college. They may reach out to your previous company if you are experienced. They will verify whether the information you have provided that is correct or not. And after completing all the checklist, they will provide the status to the talent team over the mail, or they will provide the report to the talent team. about all the candidates, the listed candidates. And if any document is fake or any information is fake, the BGV report will show as negative. So in that case, HR will terminate you or may revoke your candidature. So this is how the BGV process is conducted and the people who conduct the background verification. Now, if your result is negative, HR will reach out to you. They will ask you why you have given false documents, and if you feel that that documents is genuine, try to convince the HR that if this document is not proper, you may reach out to your previous organization or you may reach out to your college to get bona fide letter from them, and then you can give it to your HR, and then again HR will initiate BGV process, and in that case your BGV may get cleared. So this is how background verification process is conducted, and that is all from my end. I hope this video has cleared all your doubts. Still, if you have any question regarding this background verification process, please drop your comment in the comment section. I will reply to your comment, and if I feel that your question need to be discussed in a separate video or your question should be discussed as a separate topic, I will come up with a new video. One more request, friend, please do like and subscribe my channel. Please share my channel link with your friends so they will also be aware of all the job and career related updates, and your support will give me motivation to come up with more career and job related videos. Have a very nice rest of the day to you all. Good night.